Good morning, guys. So I know I said that I'm gonna be updating the YouTube channel this summer. I meant to upload 2 videos a week, but then I left my charger in Manila and I just got back home yesterday, so I got the charger now, obviously. So first, let's have breakfast. Then I'm gonna talk about something that most of my Facebook friends have been asking me. I'm going to talk about this. I've been asked about this a lot of times, and it's how I maintain my physique even if I have already given birth. So I'm going to divide it into 2 videos. So in this video, I'm going to talk about taking care of your body before and during pregnancy, and then in the next video, I'm going to talk about how you're going to recover or get your body back from how it was after pregnancy. By the end of this video, I am going to show you guys my pictures when I was still pregnant. And also, I just want to clear things out that all the steps that I'm going to talk about were guided and approved by doctors. Each pregnancy is unique, so your pregnancy might be and will be different from mine. So you need to be guided by doctors if you're going to make decisions about your health. First is, you need to know your genetics. You need to know what type of body you have. So the best way to do this is to observe your parents and your grandparents. My mom and my grandma, they were both slim when they were pregnant, and basically it was just their usual body plus a bump and a little bit of fat gain. But yeah, so that's how I was when I was pregnant. I got it from them. I was slim. I just had a bump, not very fat. But that does not mean that everything was perfect for us. We did gain some fat. Getting fat is a normal thing when you are pregnant. But what matters is you keep it in a healthy level. Okay, the worry here is that you get too fat, that you are affecting your health and your baby's health. If your genetics tell you that you are most likely going to get big when you are pregnant, then you need extra care. That's when genetics play a role. Some women are built to accumulate more fat. Some women are built to, you know, burn fat easier, and that's good. But both women need to take care of their health when they are pregnant. Next, do not eat for 2. This is such a big misconception. It's an excuse that pregnant women buy to given to their cravings. You are not supposed to eat for 2. It's just a really, really small baby. It doesn't need a whole bunch of food. Okay, so any calories that you eat in excess is going to be stored as fat. What you need to do is load on vitamins, but not load on food. I know that there is a point in pregnancy, like I said, every pregnancy is different, but there comes a point in pregnancy that you can only eat what you crave for. It's just how it works. So for me, first 4 months of my pregnancy, I was like that. Even if it was my favorite food, I wouldn't dare to eat it if I wasn't craving for it. I would just reject it. I would feel like I wanted to throw up. But then I noticed that things were getting out of hand. I started craving for chocolates, for ice cream, for noodles. And I felt so bad about myself. I was so weak. I stayed in bed the whole day. What I did was I ate healthy food, I ate the right portion, I ate in proper timing, and whenever I crave for something, I would just take a bite of it. So for example, I used to always crave for Snickers. So every after meal, I would take a bite of Snickers and then I would give it to my sister or to my husband or to my mom. Just, I still let myself have the taste of what I'm craving for. I just don't let myself, you know, go all in and dive into that. So that really helped me minimize my fat gain. I wasn't doing this for the sake of my physique. I was doing it because I wanted my baby to be healthy, which later on affected my physique. I mean, if you do eat healthy, that is your goal. Eating healthy is your goal. It's gonna show. So you can't help but look healthy when you eat healthy, right? The third one is stay active. I wasn't able to do this until the fifth month of my pregnancy, because during the first month of my pregnancy, we actually almost lost our baby because I had an abortion threat. I almost had a miscarriage. Actually, pregnancies are very fragile, especially in the first trimester, so the doctors advised me to stay in bed and just recover. I wasn't allowed to stand up as much. Mark had to do all the chores for me. There was a time that he even had to carry me from one place to another. It was that bad. But I did it all for our baby. But then as the pregnancy progressed, we were getting more sure that our baby is getting safer in my tummy. So when the fifth month came, I asked the doctor if I could start working out, because before pregnancy, I was actually a pretty much active person. And I noticed that while I wasn't working out, during the first 5 months, I was so lazy. I would eat and then sleep, and then I just didn't have the energy. Working out really gave me energy. So I wanted to get back to working out. I asked the doctor if I could. So she checked everything and she gave me a go signal. So if you're planning to work out when you are pregnant, you have to get cleared by the doctor first. I continued the usual home workout that I did. I bought this program online and I followed it. It's basically just like you play it on the laptop and you follow what the person does. It was kind of intense because you do sweat a lot. I mean, crazy. But I did what I used to do. Of course, with a bump, I cannot lay flat on my stomach. I could not jump as much. But when it comes to strength, I did what I can. I carried 16 pounds of weight. I did pretty much what I can. I didn't think that I was hindered by my belly, except on the positions that would disturb my baby. Of course, I took care of that. I was active. I worked out 5 times a week. And some people were even surprised, like, are you even allowed to do that? Well, yes, of course. It's even a lot better than just staying in bed and getting your blood pressure high. Lastly, do not underestimate your body. A woman's body is super amazing and is capable of many things, so don't think that you can't do as much as you used to do just because you're pregnant. Like I said, you might be told not to carry heavy stuff, you might be told that you can do this stuff, but focus on the things you can do as much as you can. As long as your body is comfortable with it, continue doing these things. I never had the mindset that people should start carrying all of my stuff for me just because I'm pregnant. I never had the mindset that I was not capable of doing things because I had a big belly with me. Like I said, your body is amazing. A woman's body is amazing. So don't think that you can do less just because you're pregnant. Pregnancy is a very amazing gift. It shows you how much your body can do. Again, I want to end this by saying that you need to consult your doctors before working out, before doing anything active, because like I said, every pregnancy is unique. So if you're advised by a doctor to stay in bed, that's okay. It's gonna last a couple months, but it's gonna be super worth it when you see your baby. It's already something to stay in bed the whole day, so don't add up to it by eating lots of junk food. Just eat healthy food, control your portions, control your cravings. I know it's hard, but you can do it. So that's it for now, and I'll see you in my next video.